Alrighty then. Hey, this is Megalovaniac yet again, and I'm going to be continuing my Let's Play of Don't Starve, Shipwrecked. I almost said Persona 3 FES again, but I didn't screw it up again. Actually, I'm gonna go ahead and drop that. Drop? There we go. I pressed triangle to drop for some reason. I don't know why that was my first instinct. Either way, last time we got set up on this island here, and we have a very basic base going. This time, as promised, I am going to be sailing a bit. However, I have actually had a full day at work to reconsider my options, and after briefly like skimming over the subreddit as well as let's see, where's my spear? Also, by the way, this is so much faster. Oh my god, this is nice. But yeah, after browsing around the subreddit briefly and also looking at the wiki a little bit to figure out a couple of things, I've realized something. First of all, snakeskin is even higher of a priority than I thought because jellyfish are actually far more valuable than I realized. In fact, a lot of people were saying, like, in basic advice on that subreddit, that it's advised to, like, jellyfish are your best friend. And, oh, I didn't realize we were this close to the edge of the world. Yeah, I'm going to look around for a couple of jellyfish for a moment, and it's weird. I could've sworn we had a little bit more space in this, but whatever. And the reason why they're so nice for you, also I'm gonna pick up some poop while I'm here as well, the reason why they're so nice, I was told they were about the same as monster meat as far as food value. That is half true. They are the same as monster meat and a little bit of fish when put into a crock pot. However, oh, you guys are not making your normal sounds. I'm guessing you are in heat? I don't know. I don't really know how to spot. Okay, their tails are swiping back and forth the same way that regular beefalo do. So they are probably in heat, so I don't want to get too close. Either way, like I was saying, yeah, they actually have a pretty good food value outside of crockpots. They are effectively the same thing as a durian as far as food value. Now, what they drop when you actually kill one of them, you get a dead jellyfish, of course, and they deal apparently 5 damage every time you hit them, but only takes 2 hits to kill them. But when you cook them, even if you don't cook them, it gives you back 10 health, making it so the damage doesn't really matter. In fact, you gain back that damage that you took whenever you cook them and eat them. And not only that, they give nearly 20 hunger when you eat them cooked, which is actually amazing for a very basic and plentiful food resource. So yeah, yes, you do need food. I have been gathering some basic things. And yeah, I've decided to hang around my island a little bit and wait to get a log raft set up. Because unfortunately, now is not the best time to be collecting from beefalo because they're in heat apparently, but still gonna be going by to get what I can. Whoa, they are clumped together. Yeah, I've decided to wait around a little bit longer and actually get some shells so I can get an armored boat so I can do some proper sea travel. And, of course, what I really want to do is get my snakeskin coat going. So, while I'm waiting, I'm going to actually be going over to the island that I mostly burned down. And I'm actually going to be chopping many of these burned trees. Because, from these, of course, we can get charcoal, which I could actually really use. I want to get my base going, so I'd like to get some drying racks up and running, as well as a crock pot. Of course, the crock pot will be less necessary as long as I can actually find a decent number of jellyfish, which will be easy to do while roaming. And of course, I've had enough time to think of a game plan. I haven't just skimmed the subreddit. I have decided to come up with a plan on what to do for, in each season, what my season goals will be. You see, this season, I've already completed 2 of my goals. I wanted to get the, I wanted to get the Chimea, I wanted to get a snake skin coat going, which I haven't done yet, and I wanted a lightning rod. I've done 2 of those. Where is my shovel? I could have sworn I had a shovel. Oh, that's right, it broke. I do have more than enough with my tools to make another shovel, though. Don't like so much inventory space getting taken up, though. But it's worth it to dig up this X marks spot, which gets us a chest. Hey, you do not take those! Why couldn't I pick those up? Because he was standing on top of them, of course. That's something that's kind of annoying about the controls in this mode, or in console. Ooh, blue gems and doubloons. Oh, no, no, no! Don't you dare. Left to take, not down. As I was saying, though, what was I saying, actually? I have lost my train of thought. Oh, yeah, I've got 2 of the things done, but yeah, this actually leads me into part of the reason why it's actually a higher priority for me now to get the, the snakeskin coat. Apparently, the snakeskin coat, in addition to making you immune to rain, actually makes you immune to electric damage, which is something I didn't know about when I first got it. Although, I was kind of suspecting it. Ooh, night's coming, that means it's time to go and kill some snakes. But, the reason why I suspected before was I remember getting hit by lightning with the snakeskin coat on and taking no damage, and thinking, oh, it must have just gotten close to me and didn't actually hit me. I'm gonna bring this a little bit closer to our base, and hopefully, I'm not sure if we'll actually have enough time to get some snake hunting done. But the goal is not only snake hunting, but also to get shells for an armored boat, which we have 7 shells at the moment, which is not bad, but we need 10. But yeah, once I have that snakeskin coat, I can actually get those jellyfish if they become a good source of health as well as food. Of course, I haven't actually found any near my house, but that's fine. We'll figure things out as we go. And the tide is already starting to come in. Is tonight a full moon, actually? If tonight's a full moon, it'll be a pretty much ideal night to go snake hunting. But just in case, I'm just going to actually eat some food that's been cooked first. Let's see. Yep, definitely a full moon. So let's go ahead and get off here. And I am going to go ahead and just use a twig in the fire tonight. Should be enough to cook anything I need. Alright, so let's go ahead and add fuel. Let's go ahead and cook these eggs, and that'll be enough to get us by. There we go. Alright, so, snakes, that's what I was doing. Also, I was mentioning that I had season goals as well. My other season goals, or for this season, I've nearly completed all my goals, but as far as other seasons go, let's go ahead and take these snakes out. Dodge. There we go, nice and easy. Also, monster meat. I'm not doing great on food right now. I didn't actually find jellyfish nearby like I had hoped, but I'm not doing terrible either. But either way, I'll use that monster meat just to make sure I can get by. Also, significant lack of snakes. We don't have that many on this island, I guess. I'll see if I can spook any out of this bush here. No, I guess I killed all of them. Oh well. Either way, though, season goals for other seasons that are important. I also plan on... Let's see, I don't really need to get anything going here. In the hurricane season, which is upcoming, I want to go ahead and get... What was it? I want to work on getting flooring for my entire base, because monsoon season, I found out the flooding that happens in that actually isn't that big of a deal as long as you have flooring. So, flooring is actually something I've never done for my base in regular Don't Starve, because it's not that big a... Excuse me, I have hiccups. It's not that big of a deal. But, yeah, and this apparently it can prevent flooding in your house, which is a huge deal, actually. And I will definitely be focusing on getting that going. Also, our sandy isn't great, but I can't afford to pick flowers on our main island. Let's see, where can we go? Let's see, I'd like to go to an island that probably has more snakes on it. You know, I bet that Skull Island has a bunch of snakes on it. Let's head down to Skull Island, then, and we can get some gold while we're down there, possibly restore our sandy with a few flowers. Probably don't want to do that, though, because the wind might knock out the flowers on our current island. We don't want the closest island to us to be out of flowers as well. Ooh, there's a stink ray over there. That's not good. And by the way, I did discover one other thing, apparently. Apparently, Bodhi Knights will actually start showing up after you kill things at sea, which is another good reason to be actually killing jellyfish nearby to get some gears for your base. Ooh, right, full moon means big waves. Well, shouldn't be that big a deal. We're just heading downward, which isn't directly against the water. It's just not directly with it. I'm gonna try to avoid waves just in case, so I'm not sure if I'm at the right angle, and I'd rather not damage my boat. And yeah, I will be trying to get a armor boat before I leave. And man, there are no jellyfish around here. We're not in the shallows, actually, so that makes sense. Don't bring that up, I want to bring this up. Okay, just directly south of here, no big deal. So why did it go so dark? Or so silent? This is... Yep, that was not even remotely the same thing. Aha! Sorry, easily distracted. Apparently jellyfish can be found deep at sea, then I didn't really pay attention to that before. So a little bit of damage, but good food. And actually, we're pretty damaged. I didn't even realize that. Probably from the hounds the other day. Either way, though, let's go ahead. We should be getting pretty close to Skull Island. Which, yes, I have decided to name some of the islands. Ooh, more jellyfish. Yeah, this is what I was talking about, though. Jellyfish are everywhere in this, in case you hadn't noticed before. And if they don't actually cost you any damage, they're you can see why they'd actually be a good source of food, as long as I remember to cook them. In fact, I don't even have to cook them. They still restore 10 food. I don't want to get too close to those stink rays. They still restore 10 food and 10 health if you eat them raw. And I don't believe they even take any sandy, which is why what I thought was so bad about them before. So yeah, jellyfish are actually amazing. I don't know why I was under the impression they were bad. I think the person I was advised about that with that didn't realize how good they were. So that's a shame because they are amazing. Let's see, is that a blue mushroom? Blue mushrooms are nice for restoring health, but they chunk your sandy as well. Ooh, there's plenty of spiders here. Ooh, this will be amazing for getting snake skins. Unfortunately, there are monkeys everywhere! I forgot this island belonged to the monkeys. I want to hammer their base, or I could burn it. There are snakes here. I wonder if I can get the snakes to fight the monkeys. Probably. If I just run far enough away, yeah, the snake will go back, but will it aggro on the monkey in time? No. Unfortunately, I couldn't get another venomous snake out of it. Not really much to be gained from that. Also, we are running dangerously low on food. I should start a fire sooner than later. I don't actually have enough for fire. I'm glad I noticed that, actually. And I used up all my axe chopping down for charcoal, which I probably should have dropped off at base and used to build things, but whatever. We'll be getting plenty of, we'll be working on getting snake skin tonight. No, I just remembered something with the monkeys that's something from regular Don't Starve that I don't think will happen. Will you quit it? I would kill you if I could. Well, at least we got enough, not a great amount. I wonder if the monkey can piss off the snakes. Huh, he lost interest. Oh no, he didn't lose interest, he just walked away for a second. Either way, I need to make a fire and get some food cooking. Oh yeah, speak of, let's cook and have ourselves some jellyfish. See, not that big a deal. In fact, quite good. So let's go ahead and have those. We may as well have the seaweed while we're at it just to clear some inventory space. And the egg, why not? Wait, nope. Why did that drop? I hit left. At least I could have sworn I hit left. It's possible I messed up. All right, there we go. So that's taken care of. It's almost evening. I'll be wanting to take on as many snakes as possible, but this monkey is going to cause me problems. What can I do? Well, first of all, I should have my lighter out. Oh, I pressed the button to light something. I would have lit that bamboo on fire. Man, there are so many spiders on this island. I can literally hear all of them. What I should do before it turns to sunset, and I may as well pick a couple flowers while I'm here. But what I should do is try to get this monkey off of me so he won't be following when nightfall comes and I can actually work on getting the snake skin safely. Also, do I have a log suit on me? I should have a log suit on me. I don't see a log suit on me. Oh, no, there it is. I just didn't see it in my inventory. Now, once we're at sea, he doesn't lose aggro immediately. I just need to go a little bit of ways first and then head back. Now, let's see. Stand next to this fire to gain sandy and try to bait some snakes over. Alright, that's one. Oh, the monkey's back already? You know what? I'm going to go ahead and equip my log suit. He won't take a backpack, right? Yeah, monkey won't steal a backpack. Oh, snakes aggroed on the monkey. Fight. Okay, this is good. And it's not attracting other monkeys over, which means, you know what, I'm on the snake side, monkey. Wow, how far is he going to run? Far enough away that the snake loses aggro, actually. Huh, that's unfortunate. He dropped monster meat. Monkey is still interested in me. There's gotta be some more snakes around here somewhere. Lots of monkeys. Significant lack of snakes. Ooh! Snake pissed off the monkeys. And whatever it drops, the monkeys are definitely going to gather. Oh, ow! Ooh, that was snake skin. I want it. Nope! Oh, you bastard! I hate monkeys so much. And now that the spiders are aggroed on me instead of the snakes, they're gonna stay aggroed for a while, aren't they? Snake skin. Okay. It's in the water too, so the monkey probably won't even try to go for it. So try to bite me and gather. Screw it, I'm fighting you. I don't really need your monster meat right now. The monkeys can take that while I get what's actually valuable. Okay, what now? It's almost daytime already. These monkeys are they still following me? I can't really tell. It's a shame the spiders and the monkeys don't fight. If the spiders and the monkeys fought, this place would be a bloodbath, actually. Oh, and that is a mush tree, right? Full moon, mush trees happen. Oh, ooh, and there are some doubloons on the ground. May as well take those for free. I don't have my backpack on. Okay, let's just go ahead and bait and try to fight as many snakes as we can while we can. There should be 3 snakes in this bush, if I'm not mistaken. I guess I am mistaken. Well, we got at least 1 snake skin out of that. We had 1 at base. How much snake skin do we actually need? Or do I need to be at a science machine to find out? We can get a snakeskin jacket with just 2. I'm pretty sure the other thing takes 2 as well. So about 4, maybe 5 snakeskin at most. We can probably get a fair amount of that at home right now. But I'd like to hang around here long enough at least to get a couple more jellyfish to cook tonight. Because we're not doing great on food. Also, the waves are against us right now. That's not good. What other options do we have here? Now, if it weren't for all the monkeys on that island would actually be great to go to because of all the spiders and the snakes. I'd like to get those guys fighting. There are no more jellyfish around here. Come on, there's gotta be a few. Also, jellyfish respawn pretty often. I'm gonna go ahead and take some of this seaweed. It's better than nothing for food tonight. I'm sorry if I'm still not showing that I'm doing very well. Like, I'm not playing very nomadically at the moment. Oh, that stingray ran from us. I could have sworn those things were hostile. Maybe they're only hostile in a certain season? I'm not sure. Wouldn't surprise me given this game, though. So a lot of things change throughout the seasons here with different mobs. Or just different things in general. You'll start to see as the seasons get on. Ooh, there's jellyfish. Attack! Just need to be careful not to attack these things when we're on too low of health. We are pretty low on hunger, though. But we should be able to get by. And hopefully some jellyfish will have spawned by our base. I'm pretty sure they don't have really set spawn places so much as they just kind of spawn eventually. I don't want to go near you because I do not want to get poisoned by a stingray. And yes, they're called stingray because they're effectively skunk stingrays. But yes, they can poison you. Okay, for a second I thought the waves had changed directions, but they definitely didn't. And that is a random raft at sea with... what is that? A harpoon gun? Looks like one. Spear gun. Probably only 1 use. I can't actually see the number underneath it, so I'm going to assume 1 use. But that could be useful. Especially if we're going to be... if we find more of those bubbles, which would be nice. Well, I may as well get off and spend the day on this island. Just because, well, I don't really have... I'd be going against the waves right now, like completely against them, which, as we've seen, is not the best idea. Let's go ahead and... ooh, venom snake. Just need to bait you in. 1, 2, 3, good. And nothing. More snakes, please? No? Fine. Okay. I'm going to still explore around this island a bit, but yeah, I don't want to go against the waves, and I could use wood for a fire, actually. Where is my axe? There it is. I really need to drop my stuff off at base first, though, because I have a lot of literal shit in my inventory that is not useful. Okay, that didn't drop a snake out of the tree. That's one thing that's actually not a bad idea. Chopping a bunch of trees to get snakes to show up would be good, because the sooner I can get that snake skin coat, the better. Also, this is Monkey Island, right? Yeah, there weren't any skeletons here. Was it in this run that I came across a skeleton island? I'm pretty sure that was the previous run. Getting things mixed up because I did them literally like one right after the other, and there's a lot of seaweed to be had, and a lot of shoals there too. I might go down there briefly to try to get some extra food. Wait a minute. I see a bottle in the water there, and it looks like it has a message in it, like on the map. I might have to run and get that. Let's see, I have enough wood for a fire for now. Why can't I? Oh, I'm at the dressing at the bottom, right. Alright, let's just set up a quick campfire and cook some food. Cook, not eat. And may as well cook the egg, too. I'd rather not resort to the monster meat because my health and sanity are not great at the moment. And we should have enough time to get down to that shoal, or at least over to that, treasure map. Because the treasure map got us our current island, which is amazing to live on. And another one could get us somewhere even better. Not necessarily for a base, but just for resources. And our food is fuller than it has been in a long time. Now, oh yeah, I forgot there's a totally normal tree here. Now, if you monkeys could just not follow me at all, ever, that'd be amazing. And we got a little bit of sandy back. Also, I shouldn't have this equipped. I should have my lighter equipped, so I can actually gain some sandy back. Ooh, doubloons. Free doubloons is free gold. And I realized it would probably be a bad idea to actually go to the slot machine as Willow, because you'll probably leave with at least half sand, or at most half sandy. You're following me, aren't you? Damn it. Whatever, I'm gonna go get that ship, that message in a bottle before sunset comes. I should be able to make it. I can make it at least back to the island. And at worst, I have to spend a night in the shallows by lighter light, which isn't that big a deal. Oh, I just can't get over how nice it is to actually have a decently fast boat. Just wait till we get to sail on this thing, because you notice there's a little inventory there with the little steering wheel and a lamp. Those are for modifications to the boat, and we can get a sail on this, which would mean we'd be able to go hands-free, which means we could actually travel at night with our lighter in hand, or gain sanity with our lighter in hand, and yep, that is definitely a message in a bottle. Ah, okay, thank you for appearing on top of me, Wave. Alright, let's read you and see what we get. That's not too far from here. There's spiders on the island. That could be nice. Maybe it'll have spiders and not monkeys? That could be a good area to get snake skins. We'll see for now. Monkey, are you still aggroed on me? Monkey, could you just kindly go and die? That would be ideal, honestly. Oh my god, there are so many monkeys following me now. Yep, that's three of them. I'm literally not going to be able to get anything done with these monkeys following me. Okay, I hear a snake. Oh, is snake going to get the spiders mad? Oh, he's going to get the monkeys mad. Oh, I missed! Oh, you failure! Come on, get the monkey back. Yeah, there you go. Oh, that's a lot of snakes. One of these monkeys around here has stolen snake skin. Okay. Just going to try and be close enough to gather whatever the snakes leave behind. Can't see much with this. Oh, they hit something. Oh, I can't hear nearly enough. Or I can't tell nearly enough by hearing, is what I mean. I'm probably surrounded by monkeys, spiders, and snakes. I can't imagine much of a worse situation. I'm gonna run for my boat. Just stay along the coast, and I'll be fine. Ooh, that's a spider right next to me. Let's see, my boat's gotta be somewhere around here. Boat. Come on, where is it? Somewhere. I could have sworn I left it, like, right around here. No, boulder. Rowboat. Okay, let's just stand in the rowboat. And also, why is our rowboat at half duration? I could have sworn this thing lasted longer than that. Also, waves are going north, so I think I'm going to actually go for that new island while I have the opportunity. And then I'll probably head back home. Ugh, it's nice to have the waves with you. Like, especially now that we have a faster boat, it's also nice, but it just even better with the waves being on your side. And I need to get that sail as soon as possible, because once we have that, we can actually keep our lighter out at all times, even while rowing. And hello, what's this? A rowboat. At full duration. Hello, new boat. And it has a sail on it, too. And is that a trial net? Oh, no, it's a boat lantern. Okay. Well, we have a new, better rowboat. With a free sail that has very little durability left on it, but still a free sail. Ooh, don't get too close, that's a stink ray. Yep, that's what I was worried about. He almost got me. All right, let's go ahead and equip this and gather some jellyfish for dinner tonight. Why is he still floating? I didn't think he'd be in the air that long. He's hanging around with the jellyfish I want. Is he, like, defending jellyfish? That would be terrible. Oh, whatever. We've got one jellyfish, and yeah, this is what I was talking about just a second ago. Now that we can have our lighter out, we can actually gain sandy even while at sea, which is a nice bonus. Of course, this is a thatch sail, which isn't that great. It's the slowest sail you can get, and it also lasts the least amount of time, I believe. Well, it's tied with, I believe, one other sail for the least amount of time. Also, we just need to go directly to the right. Do you hear something odd, like a ooh kind of sound? Not sure if I was the only one who heard that. Ooh, jellyfish. Let's go ahead and get our spear out and attack you. Come on, attack you. Don't get hit by the wave. Oh, or go right past the jellyfish you're trying to collect by getting boosted by a wave. All right. There we go. Plenty of jellyfish for dinner. Man, now that I know that jellyfish are so nice, honestly, I used to think that Shipwrecked was much more stressful on you from a food standpoint, but honestly, it really isn't. Also, we are at the new island. Only half the day is gone, too. Let's go ahead and get our lighter back now that we're not fighting. Now, I saw there were spiders on this island. Let's just head this way. Oh, I almost lit that on fire. I was spamming the circle button, and I forgot that was the lighter button. Let's take a look, then. Yeah, it's not much further to the dig spot, at least. I saw there were spiders near it. Are they directly on top of it? Where's the X? Ah, there's the X. Okay, there are spiders here. There don't appear to be monkeys, so this could be a decent place to gather some snakeskins. Also, it appears I have received a text message. Not important, though. Right, don't need to craft a shovel. I have a shovel. Where is my shovel? Ah, far right of the inventory. Let's go ahead and dig you. Also, this gets us bone shards, which we didn't get last time due to... Oh, why do we have just one grass taking up inventory space when we have... I'm confused. We have a stack of 34 grass. We should have room for that to be just added to combine the stacks. We definitely got room for that. Oh, whoops, not drop. Take... I don't think we have room for this right now. We should definitely take that gold, so let's say we start a fire. Both to get a... Well, we won't need to get us through the night, but we can get some cooking done and free up some spots in our inventory in doing so. And eat that. Let's go ahead and eat all these jellyfish as well. May as well. Doesn't hurt us. And we're getting a fair amount of sandy back by doing this. Starting fires during the day isn't such a bad idea as Willow, because usually I prefer to wait till night, but since night isn't that big of an issue with our lighter, it's not a bad idea just to kind of go for things as they're available. I mean, just gaining this much sandy gain is actually pretty crazy to be getting for free. So, I admit Willow's actually a pretty good character. I just didn't typically like playing her. Also, that's a green mushroom. We can collect that as soon as it's evening. And speaking of evening, I should look for the snake spots before it gets to that point. Let's see. Are there no vines here? I'm actually only seeing bamboo. I'm not seeing any vines. And, ooh. That's a doi-doi. Okay, just get it off screen immediately. I need to mark that on my map. Okay, I just need to memorize that that is there. Doi-dois are incredibly valuable. And very easy to have them go extinct. Actually, now that I look at it, this island seems pretty tame. It wouldn't be a bad place to set up a doi-doi nest. Now, to give you an idea of what doi-dois are, they are an amazing food source of feathers, which are great to give to the sacrifice to the volcano. But there's only two of them in the entire world. And they die really easily. Like, really easily. So, what you gotta do is, when night comes, if I recall, you can pick them up, and you've got to transfer them while they're asleep. And try to get them together. Once they're together, they will breed like not like cockroaches, like rabbits. I don't know why I was comparing cockroaches. Either way, they will breed like rabbits once you do get them together, and it'll be a lot easier to make sure they don't go extinct. And you can get free eggs, you can get free feathers, you can kill them for meat and they won't fight back. They are an amazing thing to have if you're planning on sticking around in the world. which I plan on sticking around. I'm not going for a get out of the world as fast as possible run. Also, it looked like the vines were all on the other side of the island, but I want to get as far away from that doi-doi as possible, because if even a slight breeze can kill this thing, seriously, you need to make sure you stay as far away as possible from it until you have a proper pen to put it in. So getting rid of the spiders on this island, are there actually no snakes on this island now that I look at it? Well, there are berries at least. Let's go ahead and eat those since cooking them won't really do much for us. No, these aren't snake bushes. Ooh, but there's another message in a bottle up there. Wow, we're finding a lot of them. Can we attack this butterfly? It would be kind of tricky. Ooh, and there is another jellyfish up there. These are not... none of these are snake bushes, huh? Looks like there might not be any snakes on this island at all, which means the only threat is spiders. And if the only threat is spiders, we might have a doi-doi with very little risk of it dying. Ooh. That is nice to have. Also, I'm going to go collect that green mushroom that I saw was there earlier. Now, where was that? That was near the spider nest. Actually, it was near where I got to... ooh, extra doubloons. By the way, I'm not sure if I mentioned this, but the pirate parrot will actually drop doubloons as he's going about his business. Like, most birds will drop seeds, he will drop doubloons. And it's a shame that fire went out. I was hoping to use to cook this mushroom to get some sandy back. Oh well, not that big a deal. We could actually travel at night now with our lighter with no risk, so we may as well go back to our boat, leave this doi-doi here, just remember that he's there, and maybe collect some jellyfish. We don't actually have room in our inventory right now. Actually, let's just go ahead and drop this empty bottle. It's not valuable to us. There's a lot of jellyfish, but I want to get this message first and read it. It's got one treasure thing. Oh wow, that's a treasure spot on our own island. That's nice. I'll go ahead and drop this empty bottle and should we wait through the night to get the jellyfish? Because we can't exactly safely do anything with them right now. Actually, wait a minute, don't we have a boat lantern? Can I turn it on? Oh my god, we can. All right, so let's just go ahead and equip that and we can fight at night now. Neat. There we go, dead jellyfish, free jellyfish. Let's see, where else? We don't want this boat lantern to run out because we can actually refuel it. I'm not sure what with, though. See, we just picked. I could have sworn there were more jellyfish around. Wait, were they below us? They're probably below us. Jellyfish. Okay, that's the shore. Oh, that's a dogfish. Also, our sandy is not great right now. Now, while we're moving around, I'm gonna equip my lighter anyway, and... oh god, oh god! Yep, that's what I was talking about, our sandy! Okay. Yeah, let's go ahead and turn that off. Yeah, let's go ahead and try to get back to our island as quickly as possible. Let's see, it's directly to the left. If the tide could be with us, that'd be awesome. Our boat took some decent damage out of that. Where is our spear? Oh, there it is. Also, it looks like this area is a graveyard based on the light fog here. Oh, come on. Okay, so the waves aren't with us, and yep, that is definitely a graveyard. Ooh, and what is that? A Rawling. I can't carry it. I can't afford to get rid of anything right now. I'm not sure what a Rawling is. Oh, I want it, whatever it is. But right now, I need to worry about getting to shore. Uh-oh. Before Willow decides to light the boat on fire again. Also, I haven't actually looked at the timer to see how long this episode's been going, but I wouldn't am willing to bet... yeah, it's been about 35 minutes. Let's go ahead and find out what's in that treasure chest and then end the episode off. I should probably make sure I don't get too close to base, because I'd rather not burn my base down. Because I'm pretty much due to get another fire started any second now. From what I can tell, it seems to be on some sort of timer based on how low your sandy is. Or once you're below half sandy is when it starts to happen. This map is so deceiving about how large things are, because we are a tiny dot on that map. Also, this is, yeah, not quite shallows yet. But decent. If we could get a crock pot going, we could make seafood gumbo out of these jellyfish, which gives us about 20 sandy back, which is pretty nice. So yeah, jellyfish are actually amazing. Speaking of jellyfish, I'm going to kill you. All right, let's take you. And let's see. Oh, our sail ran out. So let's go ahead and exit here. We are back on our island. Let's go ahead and get our lighter going. Just so we can have that ready. I want to go to my base, but I'm so worried that I will end up lighting on fire that I don't think it's worth it. So let's just hug the water here and head straight for that treasure chest and figure out what our treasure is before I end off this episode. Let's see, just stay away from anything flammable. And let's see, where is my shovel? Alright, dig. Alright, I could use those extra bone shards for making rain equipment. And, ooh, a boat cannon! Oh, a pirate hat, too. Let's equip that. It'll gain us some sandy back. Let's take these. Man, tons of blue gems. But a boat cannon, that is really nice, although it's very limited durability. We should save it for a situation that'd be very useful in. I'm gonna leave it in that chest because, well, it ain't going anywhere. And either way, though, that is going to be the end of this episode. As soon as... You know what, actually? Alright. Let's just... Okay, I'm gonna have to do this quickly. Alright, let's... add fuel. Back up. Then... cook. Back up. Alright, not gonna light anything on fire. Eat the green cap. And there we go. That should make our sandy stable enough to where we'll be safe. Either way, though, that is going... I keep saying either way, though. That is going to be the end of this episode, guys. So I'll be seeing you guys next time when we continue this game of Don't Starve, Shipwrecked. See you then.